Hi guys, happy Monday. I'm in my car, having a cigarette, taking a little break at work because we have coverage today. So I got all my computer charting done, and now I'm taking a little break. I just said that. So how is everyone doing? This morning was my first session with my math tutor. I have no embarrassment or shame about the fact that I'm pursuing my GED at the ripe old age of 55 and that I needed to reach out and get some extra support with math, which is pretty advanced. I mean, even the math tutor himself was like, wow, all right, we're starting off, you know, hot and heavy here. Really nice man. He taught math in private schools in Manhattan for years and years, and now he does it as a volunteer for the library system here. And we are going to get this girl here ready to be a high school graduate by next year. The reason it's funny is because I've been IQ tested, and I'm not going to throw numbers around, but I'm very intelligent. I'm cerebral to the point of pissing people off and ostracizing people because they think I'm stuck up. And I'm not. I'm actually completely composed of insecurity. But I don't dumb myself down. I'm really good at some things. I'm not proficient with computer skills or math. So it went well. Both of us had a hard time with Zoom, and we laughed and laughed because we're old. I have to stop saying that. I'm not old. Because what is old? What is an age? It's marking the passage of time, for God's sake. What is it supposed to mean to be 55? Be a rocket scientist? And for those of you who didn't know, I was forced to drop out of school because of the cult I was raised in. So there's another little fun fact for you that I didn't really delve into that much last week when I gave the brief synopsis of my fucked up childhood and young adulthood. And for the most part, I'm pretty sane. For the most part. I've got some issues up here in the old cranium, but I'm just happy that I'm actually doing something that I've set out to do for years and just talked about and was intimidated and felt ashamed and just never did. So it's going to be yet another thing that I'm crossing off in my new sober life and my self-acceptance. And I know I need to quit these, that it would disappoint a handful of you, but one thing at a time, you know? And tonight, I have another Zoom meeting because I'm the poetry selector for Confetti Magazine. If you want to check it out, Confetti Online. It is a legitimate online poetry and, you know, literary magazine. Legit literary. And they've actually appointed me on the board to be a poetry selector, which is pretty cool. And I didn't realize what a sort of responsibility slash honor that was until I realized that this magazine is read worldwide. So we get a lot of submissions. And one of mine is going in this fall's edition, and I found out that it had been truncated. It had been cut in half due to an editorial, an editing mistake. So I'm glad I caught that. And we're going to go over some stuff tonight before the issue goes to print. And by print, I mean online, but that does count as publishing. So I have actually been published in The Medium, Rebel Society, couple other things years and years ago, because I used to work as a freelance photojournalist, and Confetti. So yeah, your girl here is a writer and a poet, and I don't mind saying it out loud anymore. I'm sorry guys, I'm in kind of a weird mood. I don't know, today's actually good. Today's really chill at work, and I'm really grateful for that. I got a lot of stuff done early. I am shifty-eyed only because I'm looking at traffic. And I'm going to make mac and cheese for dinner. I'm making the ladies some brownies for dessert because they deserve it. And saw my son last night. That was really nice. He stayed till about 10:30, and I woke up really early again. I've been waking up every morning between like 4 and 5. Once in a blue moon, I'll go back to bed, but I feel really good these days. I feel like my levels are stable and solid, and so maybe I need less sleep. Maybe it's a tiny bit of hypomania, but you know what? I'll take it. It's better than depressive episodes in which I could get nothing done. So it was great to see him, and I'm working today and tomorrow. I'm off Wednesday. Wednesday night, I've got my IDP, which will be 2 down and 5 to go. I can't wait till it's all cleared up. Oh, I cannot wait till it's all over with and that everything will be restored in April. Friday, I get my cut and color. Today, I just wet it. I didn't wash it. And it's so long, but it's getting dry. It's really like, no matter how much conditioner I put on the ends, it's just kind of straw-like and frizzy right here. But I don't want to lose too much length, so I'm hoping she can just trim some ends and fix my color once and for all. And that's a dumb thing to obsess over. Let me put this cigarette out. It's filling up the whole cabin here with smoke. And yeah, it's like the GED stuff and the stuff for court and even getting my tooth pulled. Like, these were all things that, you know, when I was drinking, I just never got around to doing anything, like being proactive and taking care of myself and paying bills on time and getting my debt down and remembering to like get my car inspected. All these adulting things, you know, at 55. That addiction keeps you in this perpetual state of immaturity and adolescent angst. And I'm not here for it anymore. I want more for my life. And this year has been great so far, and next year is going to be even better. So, having said all that, that's just my little check-in for the day, I guess. And I'm going to go back in and commence to cooking. Usually, I have my hair up in a ponytail. I talk about my hair a lot because it's fun to me that it's longer. And that's it, you guys. Thank you for listening to me ramble on. And thanks for not judging me for my life. And if you do judge me, that's okay too. And hit like and subscribe and tell your friends about my channel if they want to hear any real life cult stuff. As I said before, I know DC Media Girl has been doing some very adroit, in-depth cult reporting, and I know it fascinates a lot of people. But if anybody wants to talk to me about what it was really like to actually be in one, it was called The Work, and the cult leader was called Brother Julius. And my mother raised me up in that. She met him and decided he was God. And I was 5, and that was my life. And I got out when I was 26. So, again, not to be repetitive, but in case there's anyone brand new to my channel, that's my deal. And you can look up a couple different documentaries on YouTube, one of which is called Who is Brother Julius? And the documentary I was in, again, is called People Magazine Investigates Cults, Season 2, Episode 4, The Sinful Messiah. Because that's what he called himself, a sinful messiah. That's it from me. I'll talk to you guys later. Thank you for listening, and peace out.